I would like to explain. According to Jewish knowledge, the importance and the meaning of 2012 and how it came to be an important date. In order to understand this, one must understand the nature of time. And the nature of time, like the nature of space, came out of nothing. Just as space came out of nothing, so did time come out of nothing. Seems time came first, because there had to be a time when the Creator decided to create, and therefore began time. It's not true that before time was created, that there was nothing. Actually, what there was light. And out of the light was carved a nothingness. And into the nothingness was brought a beam of light. And that beam of light created creation, both physical and spiritual. From the time that the light was evacuated until the beginning of creation, creation meaning the creation of the human being upon planet Earth, took 266,450,000 years, as can be calculated by squaring the number of days in the Earth, 365, times 2,000. What the Medrash explains that God played with creation for 2,000 years prior to creation, therefore coming to the number of 26645, which is a very interesting number to begin the time of our creation with, because 26 is the numerical value of God's name in Hebrew, Yud-Heh-Vav-Heh. And 45 is the numerical value for the human being, Adam. And in between are the 6 days of creation. And so it is that these 6 days are the prototype for the 6,000 years that the human being has been on the planet, be more precise, 5,767. The beginning of the calendar began with the creation of the human being, Adam and Chava. And there is an embedded in creation, there are many secrets, like in the days of the week, the days of the year, and not just upon Earth, but upon the whole solar system, that we're in a solar system that's made of 10. And these 10 correspond to what is known in Hebrew as the 10 Sefirot, the Kabbalistic atom. And the Kabbalistic atom can be seen by all of us, because all of us are in the form of the Kabbalistic atom, which is made in 10 triangles. There's the triangle of the head, composed of the two hemispheres of the brain and the third eye. There's the triangle of the body, composed of the two arms and the body. And there's the triangle of the lower body, the two legs and the sets. These three triangles, making 9, then connect to the next 10th spherot through speech. To explain briefly how this is accomplished in our solar system, well, the Sun and the Mercury and Venus are the first triangle, and Earth, Mars, and Jupiter the second, and Uranus, Neptune, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune are the third, and the tenth is Pluto. And the tenth has three, even though it's very small, Pluto, but it has three moons that surround it. Because these correspond to the speech of our solar system that goes out into the universe, And just like speech has lips, teeth, and tongue, which provide the way to make the breath into speech, so too does Pluto have these three moons. This is also shown in the Earth, in the seven continents of the Earth, in the three oceans. And all of this is a matter of time and space, because the atom itself is only spatial. Where is the time? So time comes out of nothing, and time goes back into nothing. It's the sine wave. And every time we go into nothing, there is a new moment that is created, and all the atoms are in a different place. So there are many ways to look at time. There is time in its lengthy way of 200 million years, which coincidentally, scientists, when they measure from the Big Bang, they say that the stars also came on around 200 million years ago. In the Torah, it explains how God said to creation that was moving out of the light to make place for the darkness, after 2,000 years God time, or 266,450,000 years human time, we come to the place where God says die, to everything that is moving, moving infinitely fast, and it stops. And out of that, God is called Shaddai. And Shaddai is the one of the seven names, which cannot be erased. And it has the gematria of 314, pi. And it's for that reason we find pi everywhere. But the beginning of time, as we know it, 5,767 years since the time of Adam, is a different time. And it's a time about being human on planet Earth. And like all of the different worlds, all of the different places, and all of the different times, the meaning of all of it is to get closer to the